If you've filmed as many interviews as me, you'll have come across someone who's worn green in their clothing when the shoot called for a green screen. But don't worry, this video will show you how to successfully change the green in the clothing without affecting the green screen itself. And at the end of the video, I'll show you how to retain the green clothing, again without affecting the green screen itself. And it'll be obvious to you that if you remove the green from a green screen, it'll also remove the green from any clothing that the talent is wearing. So the trick is to change the colour of the green of the clothing without affecting the green of the green screen. And it's not so easy in Final Cut Pro, as when you want to change a specific colour in a single image, the change affects all instances of the colour in the rest of the image. Even though you can be very selective with the tone of the colour by using the sat hue curves, the results will be limited within Final Cut Pro itself. To change the colour completely, you'll need an external colour application like Photoshop or the brilliant Pixelmator that's designed around the use of video. First, I'll show you how to achieve the change of colour within Final Cut Pro without the use of Pixelmator. Select the clip in the timeline and open the hue saturation curves in the inspector. Select the eyedropper in the hue versus hue section. It turns blue. Now click the eyedropper on the green polo shirt. A dot appears in the inspector's line and you can narrow the range of the colour selected by tightening the outer dots. Dragging up increases the amount of colour, but more importantly, dragging down removes the colour so the shirt turns a khaki colour without affecting the green and the green screen at all. I'll reset the hue versus hue curve with the curly arrow at the top right and select the eyedropper in the hue versus sat curve, which gives a much better grey. Again, dragging it down reduces the colour to give that cleaner grey. Now we've got the colour in the shirt changed, let's add the built-in green screen keyer. And it does give a good separation when you make some adjustments. First, I'll need to select matte so you can see the edges and then reduce the strength completely. Next, by selecting sample colour, I'll draw over those various tones of the green screen in the viewer until there's a clean key in all the tones of green. Then switching back to composite, I'll drag a background below the keyed clip. Now you can adjust the spill level and also use the matte tools. Select the matte again and you can see an area that is grey in what should be pure white. Select the composite again and use the erode to reduce the green screen and the hair. With the method only using Final Cut built-in plugins, you're pretty well restricted to a grey or a dirty green polo shirt. You'll need to use an external application to completely change the colour in the shirt. First, import the original clip directly into Pixelmator before you work in Final Cut Pro. Drag that original clip directly on top of the icon in the dock. Press the V key to select the image and you'll see the white dots around the image. Then resize at the top left to fill the window. Select the color button in the right hand panel and scroll down until you see replace color. Click it to show the blue if it's not already open. Click the left hand eyedropper and click on the green polo shirt. Now click on the right hand eyedropper in the panel and select a new color. I've selected red and you can adjust the tone, but I'd prefer a blue in this instance. Now you're done in Pixelmator, to export for Final Cut Pro, go to the File menu and select Export. Use the sRGB color profile. I'd stick to the sRGB unless you're really color aware. Next, change the format to MP4. Change the file name and press Export. It could take some time depending on the length of your clip. Now import the clip from Pixelmator into Final Cut Pro and drag the green screen keyer on top of the clip in the timeline. This key, in fact, looks quite good, but let's check it with the matte tab. There's a little grey on the neck, so I'll use the fill holes slider. Then back to composite and adjust the colour in the face by selecting the colour triangle and increasing the saturation in the midtones. Now I'll drag a background below the keyed clip. And I'll drag draw mask to remove the outside of the green screen. With the clip selected in the timeline, select the film strip tab in the inspector and ensure that draw mask has a yellow outline around it. Make sure that the transform is turned off. The button should be white, not blue. Click the pen in the viewer and click around the image. Finally, click on the red dot to close the mask. Now you can adjust the position of those red dots. But what if you want to keep the green polo? This also involves an extra plugin that's not part of the default Final Cut Pro package, but you don't need to work outside of Final Cut. You'll need to use a magic plugin from Sheffield Softworks. A link is in the description below, and it's called Keeper. Drag the plugin inside the timeline clip. Immediately, the background's removed. The plugin's set by default to remove a person, or you can change that to remove from a subject. You can adjust the edges by thinning and eroding. Now let's drag in a background and adjust the colour of the face. And within the Keeper Inspector, you can also switch between composite or matte to check the accuracy of the key. Just as an aside, this video would never have come about unless I'd mistakenly bought a green Jaguar Club Polo without thinking I'd need to use it in front of a green screen. Sometimes things done by accident can have a real benefit. I hope my mistake has led to a video that you've enjoyed. Thanks for watching.